Today in the news, we got some flaming hot news on RTX, the PS5, and Xbox. What's up, guys? I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Alright, let's start with the hottest news. Last week, a user on the Hard OCP forum reported that his 2080 Ti caught fire. The worst part is, he wasn't even stress testing the GPU at all. He was just doing some web browsing when his PC turned off for no reasons. He then checked the side panel to see what was going on and BAM! It just caught fire. In his case, it was an EVGA 2080 Ti XC, which means that it might not be the same issue as the Founders Edition cards have right now, since he mentioned that the card burst into flames but didn't specify any loud sounds or bangs. I suspect the issue to be a resistor related one rather than a capacitor one, because capacitors tend to explode. With one card from an AIB catching fire, I don't think that Nvidia will intervene. It seems like this might be an isolated incident or an EVGA batch that has some issues. On the other end, the rate of failure of non-flammable 2080 Ti's is still very high and requires more attention from Nvidia. I'll try and keep you updated on the matter if anything new pops up, but what do you guys think? Was this an EVGA thing, or do you think that Nvidia's own PCB design has a flaw to it? Let me know down below. Then we have some rumors about both the Microsoft and Sony consoles. Let's start with Sony. The rumor is brought to us by Rootnik Cookie on Reddit, the same person who broke the story that Sony would not attend E3 next year. According to that user, the PS5 is a straight-up monster capable of running games at 4K 60 frames per second. He also claims that the PS5 will feature an 8-core Zen-based CPU. While he didn't mention anything about the GPU, the rumor still points towards a Navi-based chip. One thing that I find interesting is the focus on the 8-core CPU to justify the 4K 60. That would definitely be equally stressing to the GPU, so why don't we get any details on that? I mean, come on. Anyways, the Redditor claims that it will be announced in the middle of next year and that it will launch in 2020 at a price of $500. Personally, I don't think that 4K 60 is that extreme in console-grade games. Think about it. Pretty much every game can and will look better on PC with the right hardware. So while 4K 60 seems like a big step for consoles, it's just a premium for PCs. Sure, the $500 price point is a definite advantage over a fully fledged PC, but if you have a mid-range computer right now, a $500 budget for a new GPU might sound just as good. Moving on, Microsoft may have another Xbox One coming to the market. With the Xbox 360 getting three major revisions to its name, it's no surprise that the Xbox One gets the same treatment. With the Xbox One, the Xbox One X, and the One S already out, we might get a new budget version coming. According to sources that spoke with Thurot, Microsoft has a digital-only Xbox One coming for 2019. This version will basically be a standard Xbox One, not an S or an X variant, which means that it will graphically not be the most powerful, and this system won't have a disk drive. The company is apparently working on a disk-to-digital trade-in service, which would allow you to send in the physical versions of your games for a digital download. The console is expected to cost below $200. Now, this is not to be confused with the Xbox's Project Scarlet or Scarlet Cloud, which is apparently the cloud-only console or the next-gen console expected in 2020. Personally, I'm getting more and more comfortable buying my games digitally, especially after the flood I had, which ruined all of my physical games. But what about you guys? You can answer using the poll up above. In gaming, this week it's the 20th anniversary of Half-Life. Well, the Crowbar Collective is celebrating by giving us a trailer for the final chapter of Black Mesa, Xen. Black Mesa is a remake of Half-Life, which released its first chapter back in 2012. This reimagined version of Xen looks really impressive, and they're really pushing the Source engine on this one. If you own or want to purchase Black Mesa, Xen will be available for free when available. No paid DLC, just how I like it. Man, I haven't played Half-Life in a minute, and this makes me want to go back and relive the Freeman life. All right, I just want to take a minute to thank you guys for being so positive about the Premiere feature on YouTube. I've only used it twice so far, and you guys didn't give me a hard time like I see on other YouTube channels. I'll probably sprinkle some Premiere releases here and there so I can chat with you guys for a few minutes. Anyways, that is pretty much it for the news, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Don't forget to drop me a like. You can click or tap right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel, and yeah, as usual, stay frosty, and I'll see you on the next one. Tech news. Everybody wants some boot sequence. Yeah.